Hello and welcome to today's edition of Mexico News Network's breaking news business on location here at the El Dorado Royal Spa Resort in Mexico's Riviera Maya. I'm your host, Elliot Bullman. Let's start with today's show. The US-based Pew Research Center has revealed an about-face from Mexicans' attitude towards their northern neighbor. In 2015, 66% had a positive view of the United States. By 2017, 65% of people disapproved of the world's top economy, Pew said. Unsurprisingly, few Mexicans approve of Trump's proposed border wall, with 94% of people opposing it. But Mexicans also fret about Trump's international footprint. The survey is also grim reading for Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto, his ruling institutional revolutionary party, and the rest of Mexico's political class, less than a year before voters pick a new president next July. According to the survey, the vast majority of Mexicans are disillusioned with the way Peña Nieto has handled issues such as crime, the economy, and US relations. The vast majority, 85% of Mexicans, are unhappy with the way things are going in their country. 70% of Mexicans believe the economy is going badly, with 30% saying the economy is going very badly. Although Mexicans harbor increasingly negative views of the United States, 55% said those that move north enjoy a better life, up from 2015. However, only 13% of people said they would live and work in the United States illegally, down from 20% in 2015. The survey was based on 1,000 face-to-face interviews in Mexico between March the 2nd and April the 17th, with a margin error of 4.4%. Joining me now are John and Amanda from Virginia in the United States. How are you doing, guys?
Doing well, thank you.
So what did you think about these survey results describing Mexicans as, well, disenchanted about Donald Trump?
I would think that they are not the only ones very disenchanted with Trump. It's a shame.
It's a little disheartening. We would think a little bit more sensitivity would go over well with people outside of the USA, and that's not happening.
He doesn't represent us all.
Yeah, I mean, how is your experience staying in Mexico right now?
Everyone we've encountered has been very friendly and willing to help, and it's sad that Trump seems to generalize an entire population.
In my view, both President Trump and President Enrique Peña Nieto have their work cut out if they're to win back approval from the Mexican people. The traditional practice of livestock herding has been granted indefinite cultural heritage status by UNESCO. Charrería, as it's known, is horsemanship that developed out of animal husbandry practices used on the haciendas of Old Mexico. UNESCO Mexico Administrative Officer Alma Lara said it was important that people in Mexico and abroad understand that what lies behind this art is the arduous work of survival in the fields and a long history of equestrian uses through which towns were protected and the economics of New Spain were advanced. Along with the equestrian nature of charrería came a trove of skilled artisans that manufactured saddles, ropes, and a Baroque outfit that became the reflection of the identity of a group of people that were constructing their own identity. Charrería is the eighth practice and expression of Mexican culture to be inscribed onto the Intangible Cultural Heritage List. Jorge Salvador Gutierrez Vázquez, Undersecretary of Cultural Diversity, said the protection of charrería will soon be formalized with the creation of the Commission of Intangible Cultural Heritage. Charrería is now considered a sport, and various categories are performed before an audience in local festivities in events known as charreadas, giving spectators an opportunity to see livestock herding skills. Trained herders demonstrate their abilities on foot or horseback while dressed in traditional costume that features a wide-brimmed hat for a charro and a colorful shawl for a charra, horsewoman. In my view, today, charro culture now forms an intrinsic part of the Mexican identity. Mexico's exports to Israel have increased 262% thanks to a free trade agreement that was established between the two countries in the year 2000. Economy Secretary Ildefonso Guajardo believes Israel is part of the NAFTA modernization strategy. Recently, President Enrique Peña Nieto and Benjamin Netanyahu agreed to modernize the free trade agreement of both countries. Guajardo assured Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu that in his strategy for modernizing the North American Free Trade Agreement, he's firmly interested in Israel, since any negotiator requires an alternative plan. Israel is located in a difficult area with few natural resources, but yet it's managed to overcome many obstacles. Guajardo said that both countries have agreed to strengthen the trade accord and update their original agreement and give space for the commercial relationship between both nations to intensify and grow. The free trade agreement between the two countries dates back to the year 2000. In my view, this is a smart strategy from Ildefonso Guajardo. If he manages to deepen the trade ties with Israel, he'll be able to open the door to more Middle Eastern business. This was all for today. Thank you for your company here at the El Dorado Royale Spa Resort in Mexico's Riviera Maya. I'm Elliot Bullman. Before we go, don't forget to check out all our social media networks, Facebook, Twitter, and Google+, and stay live with us on MexicoNewsNetwork.com for more information on Mexico and the world. Until next time.